I'm going to play it safe and assume that this one is going to wind up being inappropriate for the peace greeting, and so I'm not starting with that. It is not, I don't want peace for any of you. But because it may appear hypocritical, I'm not really sure what direction this will take. But as I've already stated, I'm promoting double standards, not just for the sake of double standards, but I'm promoting double standards that I see are becoming necessary in order to combat double standards that are already here and unfair. Shout out to BGS and Black Guru. BGS uploaded a video in which a woman in blue, I believe, sat in her car and said that no matter what a black man's accomplishments are, if he doesn't love a black woman, he's already failed. She is going to die on that hill. She said she doesn't care about any other accomplishments, how athletically talented he is, how many songs he can write. That was a damn lie. That's exactly what she and a bunch of other bitches care about. I wouldn't call them that if it wasn't for the lying. That's what they care about when they choose that a black man should love them. They want a black man who fits this caliber to love them. They want him to be also tall, live in a house. And what they don't understand is that there are multiple reasons why it is that men who fit their standards will turn around now and increasingly so refuse to love a black woman like that romantically. Genetically, no. They'll have black daughters. They'll love them. They'll love their black moms if their black moms didn't push them away. Quite a few of these black men have said that the first black women they ever had to abandon were their mothers. I don't know that lady's name or what platform this is on. I might do a response just to that. I may not. I don't know. I'm real busy this week with final exams and having to babysit my Bedouin-ass students during the exams because every goddamn thing the university said they shouldn't do, they try to do. Take the phones in with them, ask me questions about the meanings of certain words, everything they're not supposed to do, they do. They do it just to test some boundaries. Anyway, I told her, so maybe I'll have time to do that and maybe not, but she pretty much said that with black men accomplishing things, it doesn't matter unless he loves a black, unless he loves a woman that looks like him. Well, I look like Vin Diesel. Am I supposed to love a black woman that looks like me? I already did. That was in Morocco. She was great. A top heavy MILF with a hell of an attitude. I mean, a good attitude. Does that count? Couldn't speak a sentence of English until I taught her. She probably learned about two of, matter of fact, she didn't, well, there was one sentence that was vulgar as hell. That's okay, that was appropriate for married couples, but, you know, she learned a few compliments, good looking. She learned the word business. But you know what? And funny thing is, she tried to call me recently. I was asleep at the time. I found out later when I woke up. I didn't know she tried to reach me. Too late now. I'm remarried. I can't afford two wives. But she did nothing wrong, except one time, which she fixed. I've been there before. But if sisters like this woman sitting in the car in blue saw my ex-wife, they'd say that don't count. Even though they don't look that much different. Lisa Ray would sit up and say that don't count, but she looks like she could be a slightly younger cousin of Lisa Ray. But finer in the body. Well, she looked. I don't know what she looks like now. It's been over 7 years since we were married. But I'm saying this to say that even this woman sitting in the car, even black women that look like her would sit up and say, that doesn't count. Jet black, that don't mean nothing. That ain't a black woman. and she don't speak English. Well, I mean, you got Haitians that don't speak English. You gonna tell me they ain't black? Oh, I guess they're black because now the secret's out that they got just as ucked-up attitudes as other sisters in the West. See, part of the problem is that black women in the West, and increasingly so in Africa, define a woman's blackness by how bad she will treat her man. If she's right at the border, right at the edge, then how she treats a man can determine whether she's black or not. Let her boss a good man around enough. Oh, she, yeah, girl, she black. Mm-hmm, and she know it too. I'm telling you, one of the worst things about Western sisters, which is why you can't build families with them, which is why I keep talking to you about them, so that you stop trying. That's where AC and I agree. I keep mentioning them to you because they believe that looks have a biological link to behavior. And that's a major part of why it is that they're sitting up here stereotyping black men. And if you are a black man that is not a stereotype, then they see that you're not what you're supposed to be, but a non-black man doesn't have to be stereotypical and on his way to the penitentiary or the cell block. Or the cemetery. That's why. See, what that lady doesn't understand is that for me as a black man looking like I do to have loved any black women that were about something that brought a commensurate amount to the table as what I brought, I would have had to lie and say I'm not black. The irony of it, I realize that now. I've mentioned it years ago. That's what it would have taken for me, but by admitting that I am black to black women, all of a sudden the expectations changed and now I'm not thug enough. I'm not niggerish enough. I don't have any tats. I don't have any baby mamas. I have no criminal record, no felonies. I don't even have misdemeanors. A few speeding tickets, a parking ticket here and there that I have paid off. And regular student loan debts. But I can get my birth certificate, and I know my social security number, even though I haven't used it since I left the United States. It's all of that. See, that's where the problem comes in. Now everything changes because of, everything changed because I admitted that I'm black. Since I admitted that, matter of fact, I had to meet standards other brothers didn't have to meet because it was seen as you got to compensate. Even if they liked the way that I look, they understood that socially speaking, compensation was necessary. They couldn't even justify being seen out in public with me without a compensation. I'm not the only one to go through it. I'm one of many that had to go through this, but we were all pretty much lied to about what the hell it was. It's only been recently that women had felt comfortable coming out and saying, that's why I ain't gonna never mess with no light-skinned nigga again. When I was coming up, that's what it was, but they didn't say it. So what they were doing in a nutshell was trying to leave in our minds the assumption that we just screwed up. And worse than any other man. And it was like that from the time we walked in the room. In other words, they wanted us to think it was our fault, which is why I know the importance of telling you when it is not your fault. So she sat in the car and said this. She pretty much sat up and gave you a look into the mass psychosis of Western black women right now. And westernized black women. Not the ABW, but the WBW, Western or westernized black woman. She lied and said she didn't care about the accomplishments. No, that's exactly what the hell they want. And most of the time, it's not even because they really want brothers. Maybe sexually, maybe not. That goes up and down, back and forth. But they do care because what they really want is the only way they can feel like they're better than somebody else. And it used to be that everybody was on top of the black man. Corporately, that's still the case. And it was a black woman at one time said to me, I can understand the rage and anxiety of a black man because, you know, somebody got to be up under me, damn it. She said, if I was a black man, I'd be a hell of a lot worse. And I didn't understand what she meant because I was like, well, we don't have to just have somebody under us. But we can't afford to have wicked people over us. That's what angst and anxiety comes from. But she thought that it was coming from being at the bottom, meaning you don't have anyone beneath you. And now I see why she framed it that way. She needed somebody to be underneath her. Sisters have to feel like they're better than someone. We brothers don't want to be oppressed. Many men just don't want to be oppressed. But she wanted to make sure that there was someone she could oppress or peck on and pick on. And I see this now. And that's why it is that they want accomplished black men, whom they don't really want anyway, to continue trying to pursue them. She didn't say love a woman that loves you. She said, love a woman that looks like you. Even though for a lot of us brothers, for a handful of us brothers, they still wouldn't accept that. A woman that looks like us, we don't look black enough. And then the other brothers on the opposite end of the spectrum that the same women would say are too black. Now, it's okay for them to love a woman that looks like them, but if they loved a woman that looked like them and that woman loved them back, these women will go to that woman and say, why you love that man? He too black. They don't want to love you. They just want you to love them. They are insisting upon and demanding a one-sided, unrequited love so that they can feel like they're better than somebody else. Because when it comes down to being selected by men, that is where they come in last. Except with us. And now that's decreasing and they know it. See, a lot of brothers are still simps, but a lot of women are afraid of these brothers that are simps not being simps anymore. That tells you that there's a serious threat to the red pill awareness. Notice, I didn't say the red pill ideology and the stereotypes of what it means to be red pill. I'm not talking about acting like Myron Gaines or Amadou Fadl, who left his religion to talk down on women. Not that he's wrong when he does it, but to smash them after he talks down on them. He talks down on them, but then because they're Instagram baddies with a few extra parts they bought, which can look very nice, don't get me wrong, he then digs them out, has a pregnancy scare, and still doesn't learn. He gave up the actual solution to get back at him. I don't tell you to do it, but the red pill awareness, the knowledge of the fact that these broads got secrets that they're all in on. And if they're playing games, and the knowledge that your mother and your sister and your grandmama and your auntie and your lady cousin betrayed you if they could explain these games and they didn't. That is the red pill awareness. And that red pill awareness is a major threat to them. That's why the women of your own family, your own sisters, will turn against you if they see that you are red pill aware. You don't have to turn against your sister or your mom. All you got to do is say, look, I know that there are things that women don't want to tell men, but they still somehow want us to know. I know that there are a bunch of secrets involved in terms of how women pick men. I know that I have to know things about women that they're never going to tell us in order to not be taken advantage of. Just you saying that will put them, it will make them respond as if you are threatening them. And that loving sister will become your enemy. Oh, he's an incel now. That's a psychosis. Because it's the secrets. And I know that because my own mother told me. Now, I knew it beforehand, but I couldn't prove it. But then when my mother said it, okay, that's proof I heard. I didn't copy it. I didn't know to record it. I didn't know what she was going to say. But I saw the proof. I heard the proof. That's a confirmation. That's all the hell I needed. I can't prove it to you because I didn't record it. I didn't know to. It wasn't a public conversation anyway. If you all knew who I was, I wouldn't have told y'all about the conversation. I'm not here to take away from the privacy of any of my family members or yours for that matter. But what I am here to tell you is that that awareness is some major stuff you as a black man have to know, race conspiracies and gender conspiracies, in order to make it. And this woman had the nerve to sit up here and tell you this, like, see, the fear is that the guys who are not awake yet will awaken, that we're going to nudge them awake. And I'm here to tell you that that's exactly what the F we should be doing. And everybody ain't gonna wake up, but go ahead and nudge them. Hey, you need to see this. That's what we need to do. And when she sat up there in that car saying this, all she was really doing was sitting up and saying, you black men are losing your minds in this process that you think is waking up. That's not waking up. You losing your mind. You going crazy. And in your psychosis, you think that you're waking up from a dream. No, bitch, we're waking up from a nightmare. The nightmare itself is actually forcing us to wake up. Nightmare so goddamn bad, if we didn't wake up, we'd die in our sleep. And she got the nerve to say this stuff. Shout out to BGS for putting in a place. Shouts out to Black Guru too. Assalamu alaikum, brother. Here's why I mentioned that. Right after I saw BGS, I went to Black Guru's video. Still live as I'm talking. And there was a black woman that came on there after some other woman who's an ex-Muslim, I think. There's a black woman that came on and she said, well, a lot of these sisters don't know, but she sounded like she grew up non-black and didn't. She said she had a lot of friends that were non-black. And then black women did a lot of the stuff they do because of what they don't know. They've never seen better. Let me explain this. This woman talking may really think so because she didn't grow up like the rest of us. With the rest of us, from what I can tell. She may really believe what she's saying. I get a benefit of the doubt, but that's not what the actual reality is. We need to get rid of that notion and that mindset. She may have grown up 100 octane, 92 octane. Let's talk about these octanes. These octanes in general. When they grow up around sisters, be they Huxtable or 85 octane or anything in between, if they grow up around sisters, they learn to run games on men and they learn certain things that are malicious and intentional. That is how it is. This stuff is not unintentional. Somebody once said, you know, that she even said, actually, this woman said that many black women have children for anybody. They will have children for anybody except a non-stereotypical responsible black male husband. That's who they won't have children for, unless they pick up on the fact that he doesn't want to have children. Well, they might do it then. But let him try to have children. Let him want to have kids, and she realizes that. She'll cheat, have some other man's kid, bring that baby home as his, or she'll get pregnant with his kid and then abort the kid, or she'll divorce him and just go and have some other man's. That's what they tend to do. They are out here reproductively eliminating non-stereotypical responsible black men from reproduction. That's what the F they're doing. That lady was almost right. They will have children for anybody except what I just mentioned. What they say that it is that they want. They will have children for non-black men. We're seeing that happen. Those non-black men don't have to be on their way to the cell block or the cemetery. They don't have to be negative stereotypes. Black men got to be super athletes. And even then, if they're not on the wrong side of the law and slapping a bitch, they can't even keep a bitch. We just saw that woman on an anniversary celebration show an attitude on camera. I forgot who her fiance is. He's in college somewhere. Passport OG made a reference to him. We just saw that. We saw Tom Brady get an ultimatum from his wife that she really didn't want him to obey in the first mother cuss word place because she was already fucking a personal trainer and spending Tom Brady's money to do it. F out of here, man. She a supermodel, and you know Western women think that they never lose it, no matter how old they get. So she's a supermodel. She, you know, she's up here thinking she's never losing it. She hires a personal trainer, which means she's paying him, and then fucks him behind her husband's back. Pardon me for saying that. Told you there was a reason I probably shouldn't start with the peace greeting. Gives Tom Brady an ultimatum that if he were to have obeyed, would have caused him to discover the cheating, then leaves him because he didn't listen to the ultimatum. Then turns around and tries to take him for half. Prince Harry, light-skinned Harry, as Vivica Fox called him, can't keep Meghan Markle. All he's given up, he can't keep her. What the hell did he do wrong? She's looking at him and saying, everything you gave up is what I wanted you to have anyway. That's the definition of a man being in love and a woman being in business. A man being in love and a woman being in business. If you are in love when she is in business, it sounds good to her. But the minute you lose the reasons for what she is in business, she's no longer in love. I would say to many of you guys, look, you know what? If you have a reason that a woman could use you and she knows that you have this stuff, act like you lost it behind her. That's what you do. And say, you know what? I was given a choice between you with this, and I thought about it. I didn't want to live without what you offer in life. Didn't want that, so I gave it up. And I've lost it all, and I actually don't mind it. I don't mind that. The future and doesn't look, it looks great if I'm still with you. Let's go ahead and tie that knot. She'll turn around and say, wait a minute, you gave all that up and now you want to get married? Bitch, I just said I lost it for you. I just said I gave it up for you. I was told I couldn't have you and that. I made the choice. I chose you. Now go put your clothes on so we can go to this courthouse. Watch what she does. Why am I telling you this? Because if you're going to be in love, you need to know that she's not just in business, and this is one of the ways you find out. You remove the business profit from the equation. This is why I tell you the things that I tell you. It is not because I'm just obsessed with these O's. It's because I'm obsessed with you not being their victim. You cannot keep any of them. You cannot pass their crap test. You cannot teach them to not disrespect you. You cannot, let alone teach them to respect you. You can't teach them to love you. You can't teach them to be loyal to you. You cannot teach them any of these things. And we still got too many men that are simps and not questioning this stuff. Still got them. In real life, we still got them. So what I would say is that since the internet is where things really become mainstream and public knowledge, keep the internet full of red pill awareness. I'm not saying that you tell these men to get out there and fornicate. I'm not saying any of that. I'm saying that you do tell these men how to not be victims. And there are going to be things that good and bad women alike are going to say that they should not have to do to get a man. No, bitch, that's what your ass need to do. If you're a good woman, you would do exactly that. If a good woman says she wouldn't do these things, you ain't a good woman. You just have to say, okay, well, you're not a good woman. And that's not true. Okay, well, then there's no way we can tell that you're a good woman. We'll never know. How about that? You want to compromise? Well, I'll meet you halfway. We'll never know that you're a good woman. Well, why should I have to go and get the guy? Because you wouldn't got every goddamn thing else in life you wanted. You and a bad woman did that. You went after the careers you wanted. But when it came to the man that is important, you said, he's not important enough for me to go and do anything to try to get him. He pursues me. I do nothing to get him. The minute I must do anything to get him, he's worthless. Okay, well, now that's what he's learning that he has to say to you. And one of the reasons I say that is because, frankly, these women are not going, even these good women are not necessarily going to sit up and tell your sons on the bad ones. Then they might try to tell your sons how to be good men. But they're not ready to sit up and tell your sons on the bad ones. That's left alone to the stellar women. And I'm going to tell you what it is that bothered me about Nyla, Red Femme Diary. She had the channel Red Femme Diary. She's gone now. What bothered me about her, it's not her. What bothered me about her is that all the Muslim moms of the West, black or otherwise, but especially black, all the Muslim moms of the West, let a Christian beat them to the punch. Now, a black woman beat white women to the punch. And that's one of the reasons why I say, hold up. Let Becky stay by herself too. AC's like, anybody but a Keisha. I'm like, anybody but a Becky or Raquel, anybody but a Westernisha. There's a reason why we had that slight difference in variation. It was a sister, Nyla, that beat everybody else to the punch, even other black women, but especially non-black women, to the punch by going online and saying, these are the games, my sons, when I'm dead and gone, and you watch these videos, don't fall for these games with these broads. She did that, but when it came down to the religious element, not a single black Muslim woman that I know of got a podcast saying this. If they did, it was suppressed. And I applaud them for their efforts, despite the suppression, but I don't know of any of them that even tried that. Because it would have taken the up off. Not a single black Muslim woman has come to me and said to me, hey, look, Jet Black, these are the games that the women are going to play if they can play them. My mother did, as best she could describe them, because when she was growing up, a lot of these things didn't have names in the vocabulary that we have now, was never applied to the same context. Only the very literal meanings of these vocabulary words would have ever applied, would have ever been understood. So she described what she could describe with the vocabulary that we had. When I tried to show that I understood, I did not have the vocabulary to describe to her that I understood exactly what she was saying, and I wasn't going too far into what she wasn't saying. So I couldn't even show that I wasn't going too extreme in becoming a woman hater. Because the vocabulary was not that nuanced. Not her fault, not mine. She tried, I tried. But it's my non-Muslim mom that did this in my life. White women didn't, and most black women didn't, and black Muslim women didn't do it. So when that woman set up on Black Guru's show and said, and black women really don't see good examples of this. Black Guru said, look, when I was younger, I wanted to be up under the men to learn. See, here's the important thing about him saying that. He's talking about to learn manhood. The black women want to be able to say, okay, that just means you 9AY. You admitted it. You're trying to slyly admit that you 9AY, because they always love to take that as a weapon against the men they don't like and with whom they don't agree. You can't win. Next. See, what women want is for men to try to be up under the women. Man, I ain't 9AY. I like women. I was trying to be up under them. I'm already a guy. I don't need to watch another man and know how to be when I was born one. Okay, all right, cool. So then the women want to hear a man say that so that they can sit up and say, but see, you're not man enough yet, so you need to go around to other men. Go on, shoot, go on right back to the men so you can learn some more stuff before you come over here trying to get one of us. They just want to be able to talk down to you like that so they can feel like they're better than somebody. Now, there is that element of hatred, too. Don't get it twisted. I'm telling you that there's hatred. But part of that hatred is that they also want to feel like they're better than you. But in order to do that, you have to be pursuing them. And that's one of the reasons why you cannot pursue Westernisha. She's already incentivized to drop you and diss you. And black women, they barely have anything else to live for. That's the only thing that really makes them worse, but they hardly have anything else to live for. That's what I'm trying to get y'all to realize. That's why you can't make approaches. Now, I would say if you're going to learn approaches, go ahead and learn what you can, but then use that on a non-Western woman and a non-Westernized woman. And even then, go through a family. Do it the right way. And I can tell you, I don't regret that. I have not gone and tried to approach Black Muslim women of the West since my first wife. Now, her dad was generally cool. He talked so fast I didn't understand him. But he meant no harm. And that was one of the things I checked for first. Because if he was like, you ain't married, I would have said to her, listen, I'm sorry. I really am. But your dad has that right to say that. And I would have turned to him, and I was already prepared. And I would have said to him, sir, thank you for taking this time to meet with me. Just please, if it's not me, then please hurry up and look on her behalf for a good guy. You might be able to find someone better than me. But just please hurry up and get to looking. That would have been about what I would have said. Now, I was fortunate that he wasn't one of them super simps. He loves his daughter, but that doesn't mean he does not want his daughter to ever find anybody. It was never that. I was fortunate in that regard. But I also want to tell you guys that, see, we got too many dads that are like that. And so even then, when you do decide to make approaches, I'm going to tell you to go the male chastity route, go for marriage, go through her and the dad, or her and her brother, or her and her uncle, whatever male guardian there is looking after her, go through both of them. I'm going to say that, but I'm going to tell you that's one thing I generally don't regret, because you know what? Instead of her getting just sit up and say, no, not till we're married, no, quit playing, not till we're married, instead of her saying that, she doesn't get to say it. And there's no, well, let's see if you're going to spend all this money on her. Nope, you don't have to do that either. And I don't like to sit up and say sex for money, and that's all what it comes down to. But in the eyes of the women, it does. And oftentimes, even the eyes of the men that love these women as blood relatives, it comes down to sex for money. Well, if it's going to be that, then no money until there's some sex on the table. And even then, understand this, if that's what it's going to be, then I am not responsible for satisfying. It's about my satisfaction because I had to pay. And you enforce that. You reinforce that. Dad or brother. So I don't want to hear shit about a satisfaction if I got to pay. That's secondary. She don't come when I come, she better come when I come back. F out of here. You have to be like this, not because you're mean, not because you're a jerk, not because I'm a jerk. We got to be like this because, frankly, we have an entire world, even other men that want to take from us like we owe and refuse or tell us what we're not owed no matter how much we paid, including when it comes to the female relatives. And they don't know the game. They're told to love with their hearts and not with their minds. Stay the F out of here, man, with that stuff. So anyway, this woman sat up and said that this was not really intentional. It was misguidance. It was a lack of knowledge. It was stuff they don't know about. And I'm sitting up and I'm saying to myself, she may really think that, but no, it's malicious. It's intentional. They are willing to have, and that's why they're willing to have children for everybody but the non-stereotypical responsible Black man husband material. That's why, in order for him to be a dad, he has to be a stepdad first, and maybe not even then. That's why they wait until they've had all these kids and they're done having them to start looking for these kinds of guys to not raise their own kids, just raise hers. If they could have their way, that's exactly what the hell they would do. If they could, they would tell all these men, you don't get to have your own children. All of your resources are going to go to these children of these other men because you don't deserve to reproduce. You give them unlimited power, and that's exactly what the hell they're going to tell you first. Ew, I don't want you to reproduce, but you're good at making money, so spend it. Give me your wallet. I got to take care of these kids. That's what it is, and that's what it's going to be until they're abandoned. That's why I tell you, you can learn approaches, but don't do it for the Westernisha. That's why I tell you all, the only way to wind up with one is if she gets her ducks in a row and she comes and approaches you and comes to get you, and she still needs to be your type. That's the only way. That's why I tell you that. And you need to make sure. Pretty much the roles damn near have to be reversed at this point. I mean, why the F not? How you gonna know she likes you anyway if she doesn't? You're in the West. If you gotta approach her, that just means she don't like you. She may be a good woman that doesn't throw herself at a guy just because he looks her type. She may be. How the hell you gonna know? She can say it's not her fault. That's fine. It damn sure ain't yours either. Because right now, a bunch of us are being fed a bunch of lies. And I'm glad that Black Guru got this channel going. I really am. I think he's been on YouTube a shorter time than I have, and he's getting a hell of a lot more views, and so too is AC. And I'm actually glad about that. I mean, I'm not glad that I don't have the views per se. What I'm saying is that I'm glad that they have the views. AC does not get boring to listen to. You may not agree, and you may agree, but he's not boring at all at any point in time. I mean, and he sits up and does research and does his homework. He broke down Lisa Rae's past, which explains why Lisa Rae deserves nothing she wants. Certainly not the combination of the different things she wants. Funny thing is, Lisa Rae got the nerve to sit up and say in one of these comedy commercials, I'm not a cougar. Why the hell not? If you want somebody, that's what the hell your ass need to be. A paying cougar at that. Quit playing with me. If you want him to be your husband, you need to go and get the husband and you pay. And be his cougar. Whatever the case is, you need to be a cougar. By that, I mean you need to initiate. You waited until this age? Really? And every time you had somebody, you messed it up. Every single time. No exceptions. Doesn't matter if it's twice, three times, or 3,000. Men don't just leave for no reason, especially considering men are the ones that got to cover the expense of courting your ass, and usually marriage too. So what are you going to just leave for no reason for? No, you got to drive his ass away. Congratulations, Lisa. You managed to do it multiple times. I'm sorry, Diamond. And AC broke that down. So I'm glad that AC has the views on this channel because he usually can break down the past of these folks. I don't have time for that. I got to teach some better ones how to talk like they got some sense. So yeah. I can't pull that off. I'm late getting ready for work right now just to record this. Late. But anyway, I'm glad a Black Girl came up. Now, you know, Black Girl's nice. I want women to understand how nice that man is. He puts on his suit and he goes live. I wouldn't do that. I'm not showing myself. And if I did, I ain't putting on no damn suit. For what? I need to dress like an educator in my job, but I don't need to put on a damn suit. Not gonna do it. And I ain't laundering no damn suits all the time. Not doing that either. No, shuck that fit. So, he's willing to do this. Now, is it the style of Kevin Samuels? Yeah. That doesn't make it wrong or right per se, but the point is he's actually willing to do this stuff, and he's willing to allow the ladies to benefit from this. He should be even more appreciated, because I'm with AC. Abandon them, leave them, get out. AC's like, don't even let them come after you. I say, you know, let them pursue you. They're not going to, but if they do, it's at least worth looking into. But that's the only way. And one of the reasons I say that is so that they can't sit up and say, well, they guaranteed that they were going to say no, even if we pursued them. No, I didn't say that. You just never tried. AC might have, but I didn't say that. You can't put that on me. Nope, you need to get out there and pursue these men. Don't sit up and say, well, we got one of the best things in a man's life. Why would we pursue them? Because you got one of the best things in a man's life. That's why. Because right now you have it surrounded by so much difficulty that even when men are saying, well, you know, Punani is easy to get, even when men are saying that, it's not really true in real life. And you actually surrounded with so much difficulty that men would forgo that thing you're carrying. Young cats are willing to forgo what you're carrying because they can tell it's just too much of a damn headache. It's because you have that you act the way you do and you never grow the uck up. And I've actually had to sit up and say to some women, ain't no way that a man should stick his dick in you. If he marries you, he shouldn't do it. And he shouldn't marry. I've had to tell a few women stuff like this. Because they're ditzy. Stuck in foopid. Soon as they hit their teens and some men start looking at them, they stop growing. And to a certain extent, you can tell there's a problem because even when some of these women are sitting up and giving up the game, they still aren't saying to the men, listen, you have every right to get up and leave us. And you should. They still aren't doing it. Happy Wife School is not going to go that far and tell men that. She tells the game, but she doesn't say to the men, you know what? The real reason we play these games is because you're there. You're not leaving yet. The only reason Danielle George sat up there and said that to BGS, well, we don't have an incentive to change as long as y'all are still there. The only reason she said that is because she thought black men were never going to leave. And then he had to tell her there's a whole black manosphere full of men that are leaving your butt. They're about to, or they already left, or they're leaving right now, which take your pick. She never repeated this again. I can tell you this, these young men that go that route of just not even trying, while on one hand it's not healthy, on the other hand, the alternative was even less healthy. So they're probably going to have a hell of a lot less anxiety when they get to our age. They'll look back and say, well, I had to work on myself, had to work on my own life. You know what? It's cool. It's fine. You know what? I'm 41, no wife, no kids. I do what the hell I want. I'm about to retire early in life. Fine. I know that the healthiest option would have been to find a good wife and marry her, but I got a lot less stress this way over the long haul because they weren't going to be healthy. And they weren't going to stay wives. And that's the other thing I'm going to close out with. Better Bachelor covered a guy named Alexander Grace in Australia. Alexander Grace said at one point that he looked at men who walked away from dating and marriage as quitters. And that now he feels crappy about that. He's begun to say, no, you know what? You were right. Because even when I learned game, the effort was too much. And for what? To dig a chick out for a few minutes? Asking too much and giving too little in exchange. Man, shuck that fit. I can see why you guys said, never mind. These bitches are rude. And not only that, but the whole concept that the dating coaches have is that it's your job as a man to convince them that they don't need to be rude. No, shuck that fit. It's not, I don't have to convince them to simply just decline if they're not interested and not try to make a public nuclear rejection scene out of it. Because that's what white women do with white men. They may be scared to do that with black men. I don't know. But when white women or with white men, and they get approached and they don't like them, they do the same thing. Not as loud, but they do it in a ridiculing and laughing and mocking tone because they want the girls to see them turn a man down. That's what they're looking for. They get social approval for the same thing. They just don't get social approval for doing it all the way up until they become old, dried up, worn out, and they don't have any hope. At some point, they're like, girl, you better pick somebody. That's the difference between them and the sister. Sister be like, girl, you look good for 40. You better not choose any one of these men. They don't deserve that. That's where the difference comes in. But until that point, they'll do the same thing. Better Bachelor was covering Alexander Grace and his flipping. And Better Bachelor even said, I did the right thing twice. I married. And both times I regretted and got cheated on. And the thing is, Better Bachelor even said that his first ex-wife never came to her senses and said, wow, I messed it up with a good dude. She never did, because the responsible man that committed to her was simply not worth missing, even when she should have learned a lesson. He thought that was going to be the case. No, it didn't. It never came full circle. She never realized that. She was never going to. And Alexander Grace in Australia is having to realize that they don't do, when they mess over this nice guy, or they just rude to him more, or they actually choose one and then abuse him or take his money, they never stop and say, damn, that was wrong. I shouldn't have done that. So Jada Pinkett Shakur is never going to say, damn, I shouldn't be treating Will like this. She'll never say that. That's not happening. Who else? Gisele Bündchen is never going to say, damn, I shouldn't have played all those games with Tom Brady. And then fuck the personal trainer. Shouldn't have done. Well, she might start saying that because she's not getting half, because he don't own nothing. He pulled one of Ashraf Hakimi's numbers and put his wealth in his mom's name. It ain't his no more. Sorry, Gisele. Maybe she regrets that. Larsa Pippen never says, damn, I shouldn't have treated Scotty like this. They don't. It never comes. They don't realize that. They're not capable of that. That's why I say stop trying to teach them any damn lessons. You must abandon them. And honestly, even if they do pursue you later, you still need to vet them to see why they're pursuing you. And the minute there's a red flag for which you know one of your pursuits of them would have failed, it fails. That's real. So in reality, there's only one thing for which I would have censured or disagreed with or critiqued Black Guru, only one thing, and that is trying and giving them a chance to fix themselves, when in fact what they need is to be abandoned. You're still telling them how to fix themselves, and that's nice of you, sir, but that's too nice. They celebrated Kevin Samuel's death. And they might have, I hate to say it, but some of them probably were casting spells on Kevin Samuels. Black Guru, if you're going to do what you do, stay extra prayed up so that if they do cast spells on you, you're extra protected. Do that. Because if something happens to you, whether it's death or anything else, they are going to celebrate whatever bad happens to you the same way, because they don't deserve the lesson you're giving them. They never did. And even that sister that came up and agreed with you still did not have the knowledge, or she didn't have the honesty. One of the two was lacking. She did not have either the knowledge or the honesty to sit up and say to you that it is malicious and it is intentional, and they know fuck the work they're doing. It is not an accident. They know. It's not just a lack of knowledge. They are looking at the men who are husband and father material and saying, not you, nigga. You wait. You get the roast beef Arby sandwich looking vajayjay after we done got ran through. And no fertility. That's what you get, ninja. And you gonna open your wallet up too. Keep working, keep saving, keep getting yourself together. Go ahead with that self-improvement. Yes, please self-improve. I'll be back. Just make sure you can still recognize me when I do come around the second time. Thank you. That's what they doing. And she didn't want to sit up and say either she didn't know to say this because she didn't learn that game, or she did not want to tell the truth to the audience that that's what the hell the game is. I wouldn't be surprised either way. The point is that the real truth of it is exactly what she did not. The truth is exactly what the hell she said it is not. And that is intent and malice and hatred for you for not being a nigga stereotype. As far as they're concerned, that is okay for other men. They're allowed to pass on the non-nigga stereotypical genes to their progeny and raise their own. That's something that's okay for them, unless, of course, it's their own women they're marrying. They're their own women to play these games with them, but, you know, sisters ain't gonna do that. They already see them as superior. But when it comes to within our own race, these sisters are doing the same thing. In South Africa, the paternity fraud and discrepancy rates are something like 62%, I think. Something just came out about that. If my memory is correct, 62% is too goddamn much. I told you, man, 29% is too much. 41% in Black America, I forgot what it is in Jamaica and Nigeria. South Africa, 62 mother cuss word percent. What the hell, man? If you ain't a low down nothing ass nigga, the Black woman does not want you reproducing. What the hell does that tell you? She's trying to breed slaves to this damn day. Strong of body, weak of mind. And she's still trying to do it. She's still trying to breed slaves for plantations that no longer exist. Because in her mind, she knows where the plantation still is. She's trying to breed you for a system that no longer exists out in the open, because in her mind, she knows that it still exists, but it's hidden because she is the maintainer of that system. That's part of their conspiracy. They don't count themselves successful when they give birth to and then raise an engineer. Now, if he's an NFL player or an NBA player, yes, they do. If he's just a bedbug, yes, they do. An attorney, long as he's still gynocentric and matriarchal, then yes, that's a success. But reproductively, not so much, because they know they ain't gonna be grandmothers. Half of them know, okay, he got married and he and his wife raising their family. And she said, I'm looking like, I know them babies ain't his. They ain't my grandbabies. But I understand, because if I was her, I wouldn't be having his babies either. I'd have somebody else's and tell him that they his. So what the hell you got to deal with? It and already reached the moms and the grandmoms. And that's why it is, Black girls. And I say the only thing you're doing wrong is being too nice. Like I said, we Black men have one thing to take accountability for. Everything else, every other detail falls under this overarching umbrella. We're being too easy. That's it. Maybe I am by saying that they should approach you and then you vet them. Maybe I'm being too easy. AC would probably say no Keishas at all, period. But if I find out that AC's right about that, I'm going to say the same thing, only I'm going to say about all Westernishas. I'm going to say all Westernishas. If they approach you, you say, no, that's not happening. As a matter of fact, I've said before, and really, this is the way that you could vet a Westernisha if she's going to have her ducks in a row and then she approaches you. You know what that is? She's de-Westernized. She's already migrated to the country that you would like to live in. You move over there, you find her there, and she's lived in a village somewhere so that she can appreciate the life that she has. And then she comes and approaches you. And that's when you vet her, like, okay, what village, what third world village did you live in with no washing machine and no dryers? Where was that? Oh, I'm not doing that. Bye. I'm not doing that because I don't have to appreciate the wash and dry that we got, but you do. Never mind. I'll get one of these women that's already from here anyway. After all, I did move to this country. You were just a smokescreen trying to stop me before one of them found me. I see what that is now. Okay, all right. Yeah, get lost. Kick rocks. So yeah, even now, I'll go ahead and say that's the way to do it. I hope that what I said has been a benefit. I wish it didn't take me this long to say it, but hopefully it'll benefit you somehow. Thank you for listening. As always, Black Heart, Black Mind, Blackout, Assalamu Alaikum, Black, Heterosexual, Non-Select, Male Power, Just Because They Don't Like It, Black, Patriarchy Until Extinction or Judgment Day. And thank you for flying with us again here on Jet Black Airways with a phrase, Jet Black is also a verb. Keep jetting black with us to the wings and the wheels fall off. Gender justice forever.